So in this video, I'm going to give you some ideas for using HTML templates in Gmail. Now, if you want to use HTML in Gmail when you create a message, if you want to just use their web editor, if you go to their compose, there is no HTML option. Now, there are some unusual ways when you can basically write something down here and use the inspector in your browser, but it's not very convenient way of doing this for many reasons. The most important one being is that if you use a template, you're probably going to be using that over and over again. And going here and trying to modify the HTML every time, it's probably not going to be sustainable. So for that reason, I'm going to exit out of this. And instead, we'll just open a new tab. And we'll go to script.google.com. So again, the link script.google.com. You want to make sure you're logged in to your Gmail account. So you may already have some projects here. If you do, ignore them. It doesn't matter. We just need a new project. So I'm just going to go ahead under new project. I'm going to click on top here and rename this. I'll call it Gmail HTML templates or something. You can call it whatever you want. It doesn't matter. And in this editor, we can actually create HTML. So we can go under this plus and do HTML. And that should get a new HTML file started here. We can name this file whatever we want. I'm just going to call it TMPL1 for template one. Hit enter. And see, now I have this TMPL1 HTML. And you can see how it started some HTML for me. So here, if you have your template, you would just copy paste it instead of this. For testing, we'll just put some H1 here. And we'll add some color to this. Hopefully you're aware of this already, but if you're not, style containers are not supported in Gmail. So if you use them, they will basically just get stripped. So basically it will not have any effect. There are inliners you can use to make this happen. I will give you some options for that later in this video. For right now, let's just continue with our HTML here. So inline styles would work. So I'm going to do something like color red. That should be good enough for me to test this. So I'm going to go ahead and save this, assuming this is the template I want to use. At this point, we want to get this to our Gmail. So what we'll do, we'll go to this code.js. And all we're going to need is two simple lines of code to get this done. So we'll create a constant, call it HTML. And in this, we're going to use HTML service. And I'm going to do create template from file. Here as the file name, I'm going to pass that HTML file name, this TMPL1, the name of this file, no .html, just the name. And on this, we're going to do .evaluate and .getContent to get that HTML content. So all of this is case sensitive. So make sure you match uppercase, lower cases. And then finally, to get this to Gmail, we'll just add this line. So we'll do create a draft in our Gmail. So here we're going to have this three arguments. Who's going to be getting this email, the subject line, and the body. If you want, you can have some defaults for this. I'm just going to leave the first one empty. For the subject line, I'll just call it my HTML email. You can leave that empty too. And for body, I'm going to leave it empty again. The reason I'm leaving the body empty is because we're going to pass here HTML body as our argument. And that will be this HTML coming from here. So using these two lines, we're going to grab this HTML file from here and create a draft in our Gmail account using the second line. So at this point, if you want, you can rename this function. We can call this create template one, save this. And if I run this, it's gonna add a draft to my Gmail account. So if I go ahead and click run on this, if you're running this the first time, it's gonna give you a prompt to set some permissions. Other times when you run this in the future, you're not gonna have to do this again. So I'm gonna do review permission. Click on my account. If you have a free Gmail account, you will get this screen where you would have to do advanced and do go to this Gmail, your project name on save. If you have a paid account, you wouldn't get this. So you would get here and finally allow. So if I go now to my Gmail account, now this just tells us about that permissions that we set. If I go to my draft on the left, see, I got this draft already made for me. If I click on this, you'll see that we got that H1 with that color set. So now we have our HTML email here. So you can basically just complete who you're sending this to, whatever else you have to do, maybe change your subject line if you have to, change anything else. Maybe instead of testing, you want to update this text, and then you can hit send. And there it is, you're sending your HTML email. And again, later, once you send this email, you could basically reuse this. So all you would have to do is go back to, again, script.google.com. So when you go to that script.google.com, it will get you here. Here, you will find that script that we just made. Click on this and just simply run that. And it will create now another draft using that same template. And you would see, if I go back, there it is. That's another draft. And if you wanted to use other templates too, so you can make different drafts, you could basically just go back here, make more HTML files. I'm going to call this one TMPL2. And basically just put your HTML here. I'll just copy this first one, paste it here, and just change this to blue color and call it another one. Save this. So now I want to create a draft from this. So for this, I'll just copy all of that, what I did here, paste it below, and I'll just rename this to create template 2 and change this file name here to TMPL2 to match the new file name from here. Save it. So now here, depending on which one you run from this dropdown, that's the draft that it's going to create for you. So if I go now template 2, hit run, it should now create that blue option. Now, if your template doesn't have your CSS inlined for you, then you probably want to inline it. So just to give you an example, let's say I have in one of these templates, I have some sort of table. So I'm just gonna quickly create an HTML table here. I'll speed this up so you don't have to watch me writing all of this. So basically what I did here, I made a table with three rows in them. The first row just contains the headers, product and price, with two columns. And then I have my next row being the first column, coffee and the price, and then tea and price. That would be our third row here. So if I wanted to add some styles to this table, so for example, if I want to have some borders so I can actually see the table, you might think that you could just go here and do style here and then do something like THTD border 1 pixel solid some color. Now, the problem with this is that this style HTML element is going to get stripped from your email, at least if you're sending this in Gmail. And that would be a problem because you wouldn't be able to see those borders. So just to display that in action, I'm gonna take this template now and I'm gonna create another draft. Let me just make sure I clear all the drafts I already have. And we'll grab this second one, which will be this template 2 up here, and run that to create another template from this. And if I go back and take a look, see it's made the template and we can see there is a table, but there is no borders. Now, this is where you're going to need some sort of inliner. So you can grab whatever HTML you got and use some sort of inliner tool. So I'm going to copy all of that HTML, including that CSS I have here. And there are many inliners you could use. I don't really have a favorite. This one right here that I'm going to use is from MailChimp. I'm not endorsing them. I just know that it works. So if you have recommendations for inliners, maybe post in comments. So I'll just go ahead and paste that all here. And if I click convert, what that's going to do, basically, it's going to take all those styles from here and it's going to basically see inline them for each element like this. So now I can grab this new code, copy that, go to my Gmail right here. And if you want to work on this here, you probably want to make a copy of this so you have a copy to work on, because this one I'm going to replace with that new copy that was basically done with this inliner with all of these inline borders. So at this point, I'm going to save this. And if I go back and rerun this, go back and take a look, this should be the latest one. See, now we can actually see those borders. So if your template doesn't have everything inlined already, you may need to use some sort of inliners so you can actually see your CSS. And finally, let's send this email and make sure it's actually readable. So I'm just going to send it here, send. So let's open our inbox. That's that email that was sent through that form. And you can see it works just as it should. And that should do it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.